that we know about. But if we know this, why is the border still not secure? Why don't we send troops to the border? Why don't we militarize it? Yes, militarize it. Joining me now, investigative journalist and Daily Ledger contributor Kimberly Dvorak. Kimberly, it only makes sense. I mean, these people, these terrorists, are kind of sophisticated. They put together some very well-polished videos. They're using social media. They're paying attention to what we're doing and what we're saying in this country. And we are saying, hey, our border's wide open. And if the border, your back door is wide open, they're going to walk right through it.
Yeah, absolutely. As we heard last week from Congressman Hunter, he said that there were 10 terrorists that actually were self-admitted terrorists. They told Border Patrol when they were apprehended that they were terrorists, yet the Department of Homeland Security does not see fit to actually allow Americans to get this information and process it and say, hey, maybe we ought to close that door down south.
And these people were on a terrorist watch list. They're members of the Kurdish Workers Party, the PKK. And tell me about that group.
Yeah, they're actually, you know, on the U.S. State Department's terrorist watch list, as well as NATO's. They're absolutely a terrorist organization. And you talk with any number of groups of people, and for the last 30 years, they've been trying to, you know, take away land and take on the Turkish government. You know, their leader is in prison over there, and make no mistake about it, they are making their play in this Middle East game right now, and it's quite concerning because when you look at that, you know, they're doing the right things. They went over to Mount Sinjar and helped out the U.S., you know, free the Yazidis, and, you know, they seem to be in the right place at the right time, but, you know, they're on the terrorist watch list for a reason, because they're actually terrorists, and for the DHS secretary to come out and downplay it, in fact, say they're actually fighting ISIS. Well, so are fragments and segments actually of, you know, Al-Qaeda as well as al-Nusra. There are a lot of people fighting terrorists. We're not certainly going to be including them in the friends category.
And back to the border, though, you know, you have to bring Mexico into this picture just a little bit. I mean, it's not all on our shoulders, the Department of Homeland Security and the administration. We have to also hold Mexico accountable for not securing their northern border and not keeping track of people who are entering their country. I don't know whether it's legal or illegally, but the bottom line is they're playing a role by being the facilitator, if you will, of these people traveling from Mexico into the United States.
Yeah, they actually are. In fact, Congressman Hunter that you referenced there earlier, he actually sent a letter to the U.S. Ambassador to Mexico stating or alleging that these particular individuals got into Mexico, actually obtained a visa in Mexico to allow them to travel to the United States. Mm. Yeah, this is Mexico. These are supposed to be our friends. And apparently, these folks flew into the country and were met with someone who spoke their language, not Spanish, their language. So there are a lot of questions out there that the Mexican government needs to answer, and we need to, you know, figure out, you know, if they really are our friend in this situation. And right now, it just doesn't look like it.
Speaking of supposed friends, when we look at the country of Turkey, clearly they're going in a radical direction, and they're sitting on the fence. They're not allowing us, at least as far as I know, not allowing us to use their air base. They're just sitting there outside of Kobani watching the slaughter take place in Syria. But there's more to the story.
Yeah, absolutely. We heard over the weekend that the U.S. was successful in talking to Turkey and allowing for our military to, you know, be on the ground there and use the base for attacks into Syria. However, this morning the deal's changed, and they deny that whatsoever. And on top of that, you've got to look at the deal that President Erdogan made with some ISIS members. He in essence took 180 ISIS members, brought them into the country, treated them medically. These folks were injured in U.S. airstrikes. He returned them back to Syria, gave them some supplies, some more ammunition. In return, the ISIS folks said that they would not, you know, go in and bomb or go in and raid Turkey. And, you know,
so he's made a deal with the terrorists. I mean, this is our supposed ally.
Yeah, this is our, and a NATO member. And behind the scenes, I've heard from a NATO military source who said that they are going ballistic out there.
Well, they should be.
That they're saying emphatically that Turkey is not an ally to the United States, and Turkey is not an ally to the West. In fact, we know that Erdogan himself would like to be the caliph, and he was a little upset with ISIS, but right now he wants to get rid of Bashar al-Assad, and that is just not really going to be in the U.S. interest at this point.
When are we ever going to learn our lesson in the Middle East? It just seems like we make the same mistakes over and over again. Kimberly, thanks for all that.